Welcome back to The Search is Over, the iGEMStv podcast. I'm John Fitzgerald and happy to be your guide to engaging movies and series. We have a terrific, diverse roster of selections for you this week as we celebrate schools getting out, summer finally kicking off, and the creators of the critically acclaimed American Vandal return with another mockumentary series. And one of the highlights of this year's Sundance Film Festival comes to Apple Plus. So let's start there. Kicking things off with Cha-Cha Real Smooth. A man who works as a bar mitzvah party host strikes up a unique friendship with a young woman and her teenage daughter. Winner of the Audience Award at Sundance, this indie hit is a fresh and fun comedy about early adulthood and discovering yourself through the tangles of new relationships. Writer, director, and star Cooper Rafe is an exciting new voice, but his co-star Dakota Johnson steals the show as young mother Domino. Here's the trailer.
If anybody knows how to start a party, it's my brother, Andrew. Or should I say, the jig conductor.
It's fine. It's so cute. It's so good.
No, Mom, if anybody sees that, I'm going to get put on a watch list. I can't believe college is over.
You have a job now? Or?
We're not allowed to talk about jobs at the bar mitzvah party.
So you either don't have a job or you have a bad job.
How much does a party starter get paid, I wonder?
I have a bad job, yeah.
Honey, I'm not just saying this because I'm your mother, but I feel like you're way ahead of the game.
Who's that?
That's a mom and her kid.
Do you two dance?
We're not feeling it right now.
How about I bet you $300 I can get her on the dance floor?
I will give you $1,000. She really likes you.
I really like her. Tonight is the night that you and Lola dance your booties off. Oh, I don't know how to moonwalk.
Do you think he would be a good sitter for you?
I do not do well with sitters.
But I think it might be a bit different with Andrew. Do you want to meet my hamster?
Yeah.
I want to thank you for being so kind to Lola.
Easiest thing in the world.
I'm having more fun now than I did the whole night.
Do you have a husband?
I have a fiancé.
I hear you're a great party starter.
I hear you're a great professional lawyer.
Lots to figure out after college.
Giving your heart to somebody is the most perplexing thing. You can't just decide that you love somebody.
Yes, you can.
No, you can't.
Yes, you can. Is he your soulmate?
Do you believe in soulmates?
I think we all have a ton of soulmates.
How many soulmates?
For you, like 4.
How many do you have?
Like 1,200.
You can see Cha-Cha Real Smooth on Apple Plus. Next up, Hustle. When a down-on-his-luck basketball scout finds a potential superstar in Spain, he sets out to prove they both have what it takes to make it in the NBA. Adam Sandler proves his dramatic chops yet again with his understated but extremely watchable sports drama about passion, dedication, and perseverance. Keep an eye out for the dozens of real-life basketball players. Here's the trailer.
Taking me to see basketball or bare-knuckle boxing?
We do everything.
I'm Stanley Sugarman. I'm a scout for the 76ers.
So you're 22 years old, because you can't be in the draft if you're over 22.
Yes, I'm 22 years old.
Who's this?
It's my son.
How old is he?
He's 10 years old.
Okay.
This Philly thing, there's room to grow there.
I want to coach someday.
Do you love being away from home all the time?
Best chance to win in here is with you out there.
What the hell am I still chasing this for?
So you're just gonna give up on your dream?
Been in this league for 30 years and it's like, I'm nothing.
Look at this guy.
We come to Philly, your whole world's gonna change overnight.
I gotta work. My mom and my daughter, they mean everything to me.
Salary's $900,000.
He will call in sick.
In all the years I've been doing this, have I ever reacted this way?
He's raw. We train him, get him in NBA shape.
What do you say?
It's not gonna happen, Stan. You just gotta get back out there.
You know, I haven't been home on my daughter's birthday for 9 years running.
I'm not asking.
The Sixers don't know you stashed him.
Being the guy who finds the guy matters in this business.
Won't inspire you for this.
I just want to make sure I do what's right for the kid. He's got a daughter to support.
You got a daughter to support.
Where are you from?
Spain. Sounds weird.
You think you can stop me?
Welcome to America!
That wasn't him. That wasn't even close to him.
I fly home tomorrow.
Is that what you want to do?
Hey, you love this game. I love this game. I live this game.
Let's get to work.
You can see Hustle on Netflix. And finally, the Janes. Defying the state legislature that outlawed abortion, the Catholic Church that condemned it, and the Chicago mob that was profiting from it, the members of Jane risked their personal and professional lives to support women with unwanted pregnancies in the pre-Roe versus Wade era. A powerful document of defiance and solidarity that testifies to the importance of activism and how ordinary people can make an impact in spite of oppression and unjust laws. Even more relevant now since it's premiering at the Sundance Film Festival. Here's the trailer.
We were ordinary women trying to save women's lives, but
we were criminals. We were felons. For most of the nation in 72, abortion was illegal.
We had to go underground.
The woman would be given the address to the front.
It was probably obvious to neighbors what was going on.
We came to the surface from other things, the anti-war movement, the civil rights movement.
You couldn't not pay attention to what was going on.
Fetal death is murder.
You could not work as a pregnant woman.
If you weren't married, you were out of luck.
They were terrible situations.
The septic abortion ward was full every day.
Women did awful things.
They were literally dying because they were women.
So we thought, we can be of use.
I said, we could use my phone, but change it so that they don't ask for Eleanor. How about Jane? Nobody's called Jane anymore.
We had the phone numbers on bulletin boards around Chicago. Pregnant, call Jane.
The clientele included daughters, wives, mistresses of police, state's attorney, judges.
It dawned on me how big an issue this was.
Jane was an outrageous undertaking by a lot of smart women.
I was not there to pass judgment.
I knew there were women like me.
Under the radar of the Chicago mafia and police department.
We were all being watched.
The phone rings. A man says, "We know where you are."
There were 11 counts of conspiracy to commit abortion. 110 years for each of us. So that's a long time.
That might have ended Jane right then and there.
I couldn't see myself sitting on the sidelines.
We were building a new world, one woman at a time.
Sometimes you have to stand up to illegitimate authority. And sometimes there are unjust laws that need to be challenged.
See the Janes on HBO Max. And on the series side, we kick things off with The Old Man. Dan Chase absconded from the CIA and lives off the grid. When an assassin arrives and tries to take Chase out, the old operative learns that to ensure his future, he now must reconcile his past. The FBI's Harold Harper is called on to hunt him down because of his complicated past with the rogue fugitive. When Chase proves to be more difficult to apprehend than the authorities expected, a highly trained special ops contractor is sent to pursue him as well. Jeff Bridges' turn to the television produces one of his best roles yet. At once a hardened, contemplative former spy whose career comes back to haunt him. some of the best shot and most brutal action to grace a TV series in the last couple years. Here's the trailer.
Hello?
Hey, kid, it's me. They found me.
Dad, are you okay?
Yeah, I'm fine. The dogs are fine. Thought I covered the tracks. You and I were not going to be able to talk again. Remember that I love you, that I'll always love you. I'm on a plane to Morocco tomorrow.
What is happening?
I want to understand how your world works.
Come with me, I'll tell you everything.
I'm a rabbit in your headlights, scared of the spotlight.
I know what started all this. This thing's been buried in the ground for 30 years. I wanted it to stay there. This is not something to underestimate.
Any more you send it, ma'am, send them back in bags. Anyone you send it, my kid, send them back in pieces.
What?
There's a villain in every story. Nobody ever sees themselves as playing that role.
You have no idea what I did, who I was.
There's no limit to the damage he'll do or the things he'll destroy.
It matters to me what happens to you after this. It matters to me whether you make it out alive.
Somebody's got to keep an eye on the world the way he does, or the game the way he does.
What I'm built for is defending things. Need of defending. All the best things I've done in my life have been in service of that.
You can see The Old Man on Hulu. Next up, The Boys returns with Season 3. It's been a year of calm. Homelander is subdued. Butcher works for the government, supervised by Huey of all people. But both men itch to turn this peace and quiet into blood and bone. So when the boys learn of a mysterious anti-soup weapon, it sends them crashing into the Seven, starting a war and chasing the legend of the first superhero, Soldier Boy. This new season of the dark satire of superheroes continues to be a gruesome revelation, mixing gory violence with wicked humor and over-the-top, sharp commentary on today's world of media infatuation and massive corporations. Here's the trailer.
So, let me say it again, Cam. I may be a superhero, but I'm also just a man who fell in love with the wrong woman.
Just a man who fell for the wrong woman.
But out of crisis comes change.
Out of crisis comes change. So I spent the last year really slowing down and reconnecting with myself.
And I am very excited for everyone to meet the real me.
There's something wrong with Homelander.
Love. Mommy. Daddy. And
Butcher!
Hey, oh!
We've been on the straight and narrow all year. No killing soups, no drinking. Even follow Hugh Campbell's orders without strangling him.
Now you're just being cruel.
Or maybe you're not such an asshole.
People have superpowers. But real power isn't this. It's the ability to bend the world to your will.
Are off. That we could fight about the right way, but we can't. It's all rigged. We have to do it your way.
We're all we've got.
What's this?
Makes you a soup for 24 hours. You're gonna need it.
The whole point of what we do is that no one should have that kind of power.
For once, I'll level the fucking playing field.
I show people the real me. I mean, they fucking love me. By the heroes and
villains. You can see The Boys on Amazon. And finally, Players, a comedic documentary-style series that follows a fictional Pro League of Legends esports team as they pursue their first championship after years of close calls and heartache. To win it all, they will need their prodigy, a 17-year-old rookie, and their 27-year-old veteran to put their egos aside and work together. From the creators of American Vandal comes another brilliant mockumentary setting its sights on the culture and competition of esports. What could be a simple parody of gaming instead becomes a reappropriation of sports drama motifs and cliches, creating a hilarious and moving portrait of fame, jealousy, and teamwork. Here's the trailer.
11 teams, 11 dreams, with all eyes on the LCS trophy.
With greatness comes high expectations.
I don't have regrets. I'm proud of my legacy.
Esports is one of the biggest sports in the world.
When most fans think about fugitive gaming, they think of one name, and that's cream cheese.
I'd put him right up there with best all time.
I've played in huge arenas, gotten a ton of girls. I bought a Porsche.
Cream cheese has a bit of a reputation for being...
Hey, buddy.
Annoying.
Back when cream cheese started playing, players didn't have million-dollar contracts.
Girls didn't think we were hot. You know, not in the way they do now. In 2015, we started Team Fugitive together.
Fugitive!
You want to be Team Fugitive, you gotta go hard.
We were kind of the bad boys. Ah! We never claimed to be role models.
We're going to the LCS.
Honestly, we'll probably win 7 championships.
He never met the expectations that he set for himself.
I need to win a championship.
It's just a matter of time until cream cheese is no longer the face of the franchise. Because fans are ready for the era of organism.
Your son can be the face of the entire sport.
He wanted to play with Fugitive.
I've been watching cream cheese for so many years. Now I'm suddenly right next to him.
So you're a prodigy, dude. It's like standing in front of one of those kids who plays the piano, you know?
He was so obsessed with the game that he didn't want to waste time going to the bathroom.
People used to call him PJ.
PJ. Let's go, PJ! It's for piss jar.
He's going to be the youngest pro player in North America.
It was so dope. And then he took my job.
They want to see organism start.
You cannot do this to us. I can't play with him.
I've been here for 5 years. You've been here for 5 minutes.
Organism, pop up in the middle.
Into the middle?
Cream cheese just wants people to listen to cream cheese.
Do you not click so loud?
Everyone was dying to know how Organism's game would translate to the pros.
Organism started walking up to this purple worm thing, looked like Grimace's from McDonald's, and he died, and everybody started cussing him out.
Ow!
I hit a stud. I won't win one year of my life.
We were all wondering if this big bet on a kid with no team experience would pan out, or would it be a colossal failure?
I don't have that much time left.
You can see Players on Paramount Plus. And we do have a black diamond this week with Petite, Maman. Nellie, an 8-year-old girl, has just lost her beloved grandmother and is helping her parents clean out her mother's childhood home. One day, her mom abruptly leaves, and Nellie meets a girl her age as she's building a treehouse in the woods. The film was shot in the French language and is available with English subtitles. French filmmaker Céline Sciamma follows up her renowned period drama, Portrait of a Lady on Fire, with this intimate high-concept fantasy about friendship, childhood, and how the bond between mother and daughter has the potential to survive across space and time. You could see Petite Maman on Apple TV, Google Play, Vudu, and Amazon. School's out and summer is here. Many coming-of-age stories have graced the silver screen over the years, from high school hallways to college dorms, introducing audiences to new talents. From Dustin Hoffman in The Graduate to Sean Penn and Forrest Whitaker in Fast Times at Ridgemont High, Kristen Stewart in Adventureland, and Matthew McConaughey in Dazed and Confused. Take a trip down memory lane or discover a few festival faves that may have fallen under your radar. And that's a wrap for the iGEMS TV Guide this week. Hope you have a great weekend and enjoy these iGEMS selections. Until next time, the search is over.